Now, here, your question is, which term of the sequence is 128? Here, so first of all, you have to determine, is this AP or GP? So, to find out AP, what we should do? 2 root 2 minus 2. So, if 2 I'll take common, I'm having root 2 minus 1. If I'll take this 4 minus 2 root 2, 2 I'll take common, I'm getting here 2 minus root 2. Again, if root 2 I'll take common, I'm getting root 2 minus 1. So, here it was 2 in a bracket root 2 minus 1. And this one is 2 into root 2 in a bracket root 2 minus 1. You can observe here difference is not common. So, it is not an AP. Now, I will check its ratio. That is its ratio coming constant or not. So, what I will do? 2 root 2 upon 2. So, here 2 2 cancel out, which is equals to I am getting root 2. Here, 4 upon 2 root 2. So, 2, 2 is root 2 into root 2. Again, root 2. So, now here you can observe, ratio is common, ratio is constant. So, given sequence is GP. So, here I will write, here, given sequence is GP, means a geometric progression. So, your first term is 2, R is root 2. Now, we are asking which term is 128. So, here I have to apply term formula. Tn is equals to AR to the power n minus 1. Tn means the last term. Here, last term, what I have to find? 128 is which term? So, this one I will consider as nth term. So, 128 is equals to A 2 R root 2 to the power n minus 1. 2 64s are. So, 64 is equals to root 2 to the power n minus 1. So, here what I can write? It is 2 to the power 6. 2 to the power 6 means 64. 2 2 is 4 2 is 8 2 is 16 2 is 32 2 is 64. And here, if I remove this root, it will be 1 by 2. So, I will get 2 to the power n minus 1 upon 2. Now, you can observe, bases are same. So, I can equate power. So, here I can write 6 is equals to n minus 1 upon 2. So, 12 is equals to n minus 1. So, 13 is equals to n. So, 13th term of a GP is 128. Here, I want to discuss one more question. Based on term only. This one is the last question which is based on term. Now, observe one more question. For what value of x the numbers minus 2 by 7, comma x, comma minus 7 by 2 are in GP? Here, we have to find out value of x. So, in a GP, while I have given an introduction, in that module, I have given one result that B square is equals to AC. A means first term, B means second term, C means a third term. So, this result here we have to use. So, B is X square, which is equals to A is minus 2 by 7, C is minus 7 by 2. Minus minus cut, 2 2 cut, 7 7 cut. So, here X square equals to 1. So, X will be plus or minus. So, hope this question understood to you. Some more practice questions are also given in an assignment. You can practice it at your home. Thank you.